Winter hasn't even begun, but it's time to start talking spring as Rhode Island looks for its next cherry blossom princess to represent the state at the National Cherry Blossom Festival in Washington, D.C. next year. Joining us this morning is the reigning princess, Kim Kaloudian. Good morning.
Good morning.
So, first and foremost, tell us about the Cherry Blossom Princess. What is it?
So the Cherry Blossom Princess program is this fantastic opportunity for young women between the ages of 19 and 24. Basically, when you're crowned Cherry Blossom Princess, you get to go down to the National Cherry Blossom Festival in Washington, D.C. Mm-hmm. in the spring, and you get to see all of those beautiful cherry blossoms in bloom. And it's basically, I consider it sort of like a backstage pass to all that Washington, D.C. has to offer. There's amazing cultural opportunities. You get to learn about leadership and international relations, and it's really just a once-in-a-lifetime experience for young women.
This sounds then quite different than your typical beauty pageant.
Yes.
This is not.
It is not a beauty pageant. Yes, I'm wearing a crown and a sash, but it is not a beauty pageant. It's really based on young girls' achievements, so their community service, their education, their workplace achievements. So it's not based on a dress or a swimsuit, and really the application process has nothing to do with what you look like or your stage presence or anything like that. You send in a resume and an essay and talk about, you know, why you should represent your home state of Rhode Island. And even when you're down in D.C. with the other representatives from across the country, there's no competition. The Cherry Blossom Queen, who gets to go to Japan for an amazing 2 weeks experience there, which is just fantastic. She's chosen at random, a spin of a wheel, and whoever it lands on is the Cherry Blossom Queen.
Oh,
so there's no competition, no pageant at all.
Everyone has a fair chance.
Exactly.
And if you haven't been to D.C. around that time, it really is beautiful. I've been fortunate enough to see the cherry blossoms in bloom, and you're right, just to be there in that element is certainly something. So tell us then how we can get involved. You said women or young girls 19 to 24.
Yes. So you just have to sort of have a relationship with Rhode Island. You don't have to be born here, but if you go to college here, if you have lived here for a while, or if it is your home state like me, you can apply. 19 to 24 are the age requirements. And yeah, you just have to send in an essay talking about yourself and a one-page resume, and you can send that to ristatesociety.com. @gmail.com. You can also ask any questions. The Rhode Island State Society is the nonprofit organization that oversees the Cherry Blossom Princess program.
Great. Now, in addition to going to DC in the spring, have you been able to do anything further from that, given this title?
Yeah, so the main thing is that Cherry Blossom Festival, excuse me, in D.C., but there's also a Rhode Island Cherry Blossom Festival, which some people don't know about, but it takes place in the Blackstone Valley. The Blackstone Valley Tourism Council runs the Cherry Blossom Festival, so the princess, of course, has to take part in that, which is absolutely lovely. And I've had the opportunity to go to some elementary schools and read books to school children and just really promote, you know, leadership for young women.
Giving people a lot of hope, that's for sure. Kim, thank you so much.
Thanks, Michaela.
Congratulations. I'm sorry to say you're going to have to give your reign to the next Cherry Blossom Princess. So if you'd like to apply to become Rhode Island's next Cherry Blossom Princess, head on over to the Rhode Show page at WPRI.com for more details.